The branch of forensic science that deals with voice analysis is called audio forensics. The main areas of voice analysis covered by an expert are speaker recognition, speaker profiling, comprehensive enhancement of audio recording, transcription and analysis of disputed utterances, and authenticity or integrity examination of audio recordings. The study of audio forensics is based on the foundation of acoustics and audio engineering. The study of acoustics involves the physical principles of sound propagation in the air. Audio forensic evidences generally comprise of an audio recording. These recordings can be analog or digital depending upon their representation within the recording and playback systems. The human voice results from an expiratory energy that is used to generate noises or move vocal cords that generate voiced sounds. Speech production is composed of two basic mechanical functions, namely phonation and articulation. The frequency range of normal speech signal is 80 to 8000 Hz with dynamic range of 60 to 70 Dolby. The average fundamental frequency of vibration of vocal cords called pitch is between 180 and 300 Hz for female and 300 to 600 Hz for children and between 90 to 140 Hz for males. Voice spectrography. Spectrographic analysis is the process of making visual representation of sound waves. Speech spectrography was first developed at Bell Telephone Laboratories in 1941 and was used for military purposes during World War II. The validity of spectrographic analysis of the human voice is based on the theory that each person's manner of speaking is unique because of variations in the size and the manner in which the throat, nasal, and oral cavities are coupled. The process of converting speech to its visual representation is accomplished by a spectrograph. The recording of an unknown voice is analyzed by an electronic filter and graphed on a paper by an electronic stylus, which is then activated by the energy produced by the voice. The result is a spectrogram showing the relation of the voice's amplitude, frequency, and time. An examiner visually compares this to other spectrograms of known voices in an attempt to identify the unknown voice. The legal aspect. The Supreme Court of India, in a path-breaking dynamic judgment, has rationalized the law relating to the admissibility of the electronic evidence, particularly in the view of provision of Section 65B of the Indian Evidence Act. Section 54A of the CRPC provides for videography of the identification process and provision to Section 164(1) of CRPC to provide audio-video recording of confession or statement under the said provision.